going fast, makes me feel alive. My heart beats in hyperdrive. Do you think you could win? Only if I lose, just let destiny choose.
What's up, everyone? Neo Scyther here, getting back to Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist Link Evolution. And it's time to move on to Truth and Consequences, where we are playing as Akiza for only the second time. I mean, don't get me wrong, I have praised 5Ds for letting us use multiple duelists throughout the series. I really wish we were able to play as Akiza more than once, though. That happened. So yes, there is only one Dark Signer left, and it's up to Akiza to take her down. And that's it. So this will definitely be one where if I lose, I will definitely be re-recording the story part. One whole still image. No idea what kind of deck Misty uses. I've not actually seen this duel. We know what Akiza uses, though. Wow, that's a hand. Oh good, each time a spell card is activated, and that's all. Each time a spell card is activated, gain 500 life points immediately after it resolves. So what we got? So we got Evil Thorn, you contribute this card, inflict 300 damage to your opponent, and if you do, you can special summon up to 2 Evil Thorns from your deck in attack position, but their effects cannot be activated. Okay. Glow Up Bulb. If this card is in your graveyard, you can send the top card of your deck to the graveyard, and if you do, special summon this card. You can only use this effect of Blow Up Bulb once per duel. Spore. If this card is in your graveyard, you can banish one other plant monster from your graveyard. Special summon this card. If you do, increase this level by the level of that banished monster. Violet Witch. If this card is destroyed by battle, send to the graveyard. Add one plant-type monster with 1500 or less defense from your deck to your hand. I'll get the trap in just a minute. Twilight Rose Knight. Monsters your opponent controls cannot target plant monsters for attacks. When this card is normal summoned, you can special summon one level 4 lower plant monster from your hand. And when a plant type monster you control is targeted for an attack, destroy all attack position monsters your opponent controls. Okay, let's go and set Wall of Thorns. Trying to see how I get the most from this. And what do I got in the graveyard right now? Or in that, not the graveyard, extra deck. Splendid Rose, which is just one tuner or one or more non-tuners. At once per turn, you can banish one plant-type monster from your graveyard. Then target one face-up monster your opponent controls. Have the target's attack until the end turn. Or end of the turn. During the battle phase of this card, attack, you can banish one plant-type monster from your graveyard, have this card attacked at the end of the turn. If you do, you can make a second attack. Okay. And of course, Black Rose, that's the 6. Black Rose Dragon is a 7. Too bad I don't have a plant monster on the hand here, on the deck. Okay, so we're going to hang on the Twilight Rose Knight. We're actually going to go ahead and summon Violet Witch. Because I can combo, because if it goes away, I get a plant-type monster, 1500 or less defense for my deck. As long as I can find a level 4 that's not a tuner. So we'll see how far this goes. I tend to have plans that either backfire or I don't get to put them off. Messenger of Peace. Oh. Okay. $1,500 or more attack cannot attack. Any of these not? No, none of these can get rid of spells. Okay. So things with 1500 or more attack cannot actually attack. I'm okay with that. I can put another Violet Witch out. The problem is I know this game too well. So basically, you want to pay 100 life points to keep Messenger of Peace on the field. And we're no stranger to Messenger of Peace. We've seen it before, and it's completely locked us down in the past. But right now, it's not really doing much for Misty. Alright, so I get something with 1500 or less defense. Once per turn, I contribute one face-up plant monster, special summon one plant monster from my deck. Rose Fairy, this card added to your deck from your hand by card effect. You can special summon this card. Rose Fairy's not bad. The big problem, though, is her monster's 1400 attack. So Rose Fairy would immediately go on the field. Man, this is gonna be a tough choice. I mean, Bonfire Blossom would help for defense. Rose Fairy just immediately go on the field. You know, let's go and do Rose Fairy. That's my hope right there. Might have to bait it out. Let's see. Boy, how do I want to do this? I want to keep Twilight Rose Knight there. Man, I'm trying to figure out how I want to do this. Let's go ahead and summon Thorn. To change Violet Witch to defense mode, activate the effect of Evil Thorn. I've only got one more in my deck. I can't use its effect. So its effect is pretty much blank at this point. The good news is, I'm going to see if I can bait out an attack so I can use Wall of Thorns. helps a little bit. Okay, what do we got here? Target one plant type monster on the field, destroy that target, and if you do, draw one card. Then if that card is a plant type monster, you can reveal it and draw one more card. I'm okay with that. Let's go ahead and do Fragrant Storm. I'm gonna go ahead and do Evil Thorn. I can't tribute it anyways at this point. Yes, absolutely. Got his plant type monster. Nice. She's gonna get life points for that, that's fine. So let's see. Hedge Guard. During either or during damage calculation, either player's turn, when a monster you control attacks or is attacked, I can send this card from my hand to the graveyard, half the attack of the monster you control until the end of this turn. But that monster cannot be destroyed by battle. The other one we got was Dark Verger. When a plant type tuner monster is normal summoned to your side of the field, you can special summon this card from your graveyard. Okay. So at this point, we're going to go ahead and change these back to attack position. And I need to start getting something out in terms of damage. I mean, right now, as long as Messenger of Peace is out, this is going to be kind of, I just need to get damage out. Here's a catch. I can go ahead and bring out either of these. The problem... Okay, so I can't have my own attack. Darn it. Okay, so yeah. Synchro Summoning's not going to do me anything. Oh, that. I'm good. It's basically saying I can tribute that to have my attack and my monster won't be destroyed. I'm okay with this, though. Alright, and we are... It's about as best as I can do. Still got that... pile of thorns for defense. Set Call to Haunted. What do I got in here? So base is all going to depend on what that face down is. Oh wait, that card... Oh, you gotta be kidding me. This card cannot be destroyed by battle. The attack of any monster that battles this card becomes zero at the end of the battle phase. During your end phase, change this face-up defense position card and field face-up attack position. Oh, wait a minute. So basically, it's an invincible card. Are you kidding? But it's reducing permanently. Wait a minute. Oh, so it's permanently reducing my attack, but... I may still have it, because... Oh, no, wait. No, I can't. Oh wait, at the end of the battle phase, which means damage would still go through. So this is going to be a risk. If this works, this should end the duel. Did it go to zero? Oh, because it's not the end of the battle phase. And that's it. I was a little worried there for a moment. But, yeah, that was a risk. Because I was risking having nothing on my field that could attack. So the final Dark Signer is done, but we now apparently have another Dark Signer. So we have the next campaign, Duel Signs of Doom, which I believe is the season 2 finale? I think, I need to verify that. Yeah, Signs of Doom is in the animated three-part season finale for season 2. We have the Truth and Consequences reverse duel unlocked, the Misty Tredwell deck avatar, her immortal Karayua deck recipe, paralyzing reptilian challenge deck, another earthbound immortal we never saw, Mausoleum of the Emperor, Dragon Queen of Tragic Endings, and 1108 victory duel points. 100 for the win, 24 for number of turns, 2 for spells, 2 for traps, 30 for difference in life points, and 20 for maximum damage inflicted. So, once again, we're going to take a look at that Earthbound Immortal card we never got to see. Go to a random deck here. Could filter this, but this is about as fast. There you go. Earthbound Immortal, Cucaracha, I don't know. The usual stuff. If this card destroyed by card effect, except by its own effect, destroy all cards on the field. Alrighty then. That's a thing. So yes, bit of a long video. If for nothing, then I'm sitting here playing chess, trying to figure out what my next move needs to be. So with that, that's all I got for this video. I thank you guys for watching. I hope you're enjoying the project so far, and I will see you next time. See the sun arise and fire.